ChargerLab took apart the Apple 35W compact charger several days ago. You can click the upright corner to take a look. And today, let's try to test its charging performance and see how it works. Firstly, let's briefly introduce this charger. If you want to see the specific test, you can choose the different chapters below. The pure white packaging continues the Apple design, and you can insert two USB-C cables into this charger. Open the box, there is only a charger without a cable. The top and side of the charger adopt glossy white shell with rounded corners. The input ports of this charger are foldable but not detachable. Two white USB-C output ports are side by side, pretty special. The slight hollows on two sides can facilitate the user to hold it more tightly. The specs info is at the bottom, model is A2579. It can support wide range input of 120-240V, 50 or 60Hz, and output of 20V, 1.75A, 15V, 2.33A, 9V, 3A, 5V, 3A. The manufacturer is Cellcom Technology. The size of this charger is about 49x49x28mm, and the weight is about 104 grams. So the power density is about 0.51 W³/cm. Compared to the previous Apple 30W charger, the size is smaller but has two USB-C ports. The ChargerLab Power ZKT002 shows the USB-C can only support PD 3.0. It can support four fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 2.33A, and 20V, 1.75A. The specs of these two USB-C ports are the same. Then let's test its charging compatibility. It can reach 35W when only charge the MacBook, and it can reach maximum power when charging iPhone and iPad, but it's only around 16W when charging Android phones. Here are the compatibility test results of this charger. When we charge two iPads, the power is divided into 16.5W. As for iPhone and AirPods, the iPhone gets higher power than AirPods. And the most important question is, will it reconnect when inserting the second device? After our testing, the answer is no. The charging power of the first device dropped to almost zero, but it won't be disconnected, and it'll go back to normal very soon. Since the M2 MacBook Air is still unavailable, we have to use this charger to charge the M1 MacBook Air fully. The charging process is roughly divided into four parts with a maximum power of 32.93 watts. It takes 2 hours and 24 minutes to charge fully. We also found it can reach 31% in half an hour and 61% in an hour. As for the standby power part, the no low power consumption of the charger at 220 volts, 50 Hz is 0.063 watts, which is about 0.55 kilowatt hour in 1 year. And the no low power consumption at 110 volts, 60 Hz is 0.059 watts, which is about 0.51 kilowatt hour in 1 year. That's pretty low. In the conversion efficiency test, the conversion efficiency varies from 87.13% to 91.23% at 220 volts, 50 Hz. The conversion efficiency varies from 87.3% to 91.13% at 110 volts, 60 Hz. It can reach more than 90%, which is excellent among PD chargers. Next, let's test its ripple. Firstly, let's see the 220 volts, 50 Hz. When the output is 5 volts, 0 amp, the highest ripple is 72 millivolts peak to peak. When the output is 9 volts, 0 amp, the lowest ripple is 32 millivolts peak to peak. Then switch to 110 volts, 60 Hz. When the output is 15 volts, 0 amp, and 20 volts, 0 amp, the highest ripple is 40 millivolts peak to peak. When the output is 9 volts, 0 amp, the lowest ripple is 32 millivolts peak to peak. Then let's see the difference when loaded. Firstly, let's see the 220 volts, 50 Hz. When the output is 5 volts, 3 amp, the highest ripple is 112 millivolts peak to peak. When the output is 15 volts, 2.33 amp, and 20 volts, 1.75 amp, the lowest ripple is 88 millivolts peak to peak. Then switch to 110 volts, 60 Hz. When the output is 5V 2A and 5V 3A, the high throughput is 104 mV peak-to-peak. When the output is 9V 2A, the low throughput is 88 mV peak-to-peak. And then we'll put it into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the test and let it run for an hour. And firstly, the maximum temperature on two sides are 52.7 degrees Celsius and 50.4 degrees Celsius under 220 volts, 50 Hz. Then the maximum temperature on two sides is 54.3 degrees Celsius and 51.6 degrees Celsius under 110 volts, 60 Hz. We also tested the full load performance of this charger. We adjusted the charger to 20 volts, 1.75 amp, 35 watts. And let it run continuously for an hour. The voltage and current curves are horizontal and straight during the test without overbridge fluctuations, so it's quite stable under long-term full load conditions. Well, that's all performance tests of this compact version of the Apple 35W charger. It successfully solved the reconnection issue of the multi-port chargers and performs well in all aspects. But 35W is not enough in some cases. We'll also bring the performance test of another 35W charger. If you like this video, please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!